What I think is special about the love in VR is that it just has no boundaries, it has no limit. In VR, we can be whoever we want or whatever we want. Kia ora, my name is Sarah from New Zealand. This is my fiancé, Chris, from New York City. And we met in virtual reality and fell in love.
I was lucky to be on a specific night where I was with a friend hopping worlds, and that's where I met Sarah, and things just went from there, honestly. It was love at first accent.
Yes, but don't forget, remember, you thought I was Australian.
It was a guess, and everyone guessed that.
So we just started talking, got to know each other, and spent a couple of months getting to know each other and started dating. And then in June, he actually surprised me, sent me a ring through the mail, and asked the question for me to marry him, and I, of course, said yes. So now I'm just currently working on saving up so that I can go over to the States.
This scene is beautiful, when you just fall asleep and you have all the fish, the jellyfish, and then every once in a while you get the big whale that passes by.
The biggest challenges to having a relationship in VR is that physicality isn't there. It is easy to feel somewhat lonely when you don't have the ability to just go up and give someone a hug or give them a kiss and things like that. I mean, this is as close as we can get right now. And having the avatars which can interact with each other and move the hair and things like that, it does give it a bit more of a depth of realism, but it does feel a little bit lacking at times. And as for the more intimate side of things, I'll be very honest, there are accessories that can help with that. There is a brand of toys which can be used and connected to the internet, so Chris has complete control of the accessories when we decide to let loose and have a little bit of fun every once in a while.
Just turn you off. It's okay, I think you're a good fellow. You sit next to me over here.
So my dating history was very, very rocky. I've gonna be very honest, I've never really had much luck in real life with guys from New Zealand. So in terms of the attraction, in VRChat, it does work a little bit differently to real life, but I kind of prefer it. I've seen a lot of times with my real life friends who they've just jumped into a relationship with someone they happen to like the appearance of without actually getting to know them, and it always didn't work. They'd usually not pay any attention to their flaws or the incompatibilities with the personalities. I like this one. It's cute. Little octopus.
Does it go in that out?
It doesn't have physics. I can't chuck it.
That doesn't have physics. This reminds me.
You might
want to
put it down on the table. There you go.
We do definitely have some warnings for people about dating in virtual reality or even just virtual reality in general. It is easy for people to pretend to be something they're not. So you really do want to spend time with people and get to really know them before you make the decision that you want to be with them.
People lie about their age, and that's very, very dangerous. So the best thing always is to make sure you really truly know someone as much as humanly possible before ever going beyond friendship.
And we do recommend that if you do start getting close to someone, do have a few sessions of video calls. Chris and I know exactly what each other look like. We've eliminated any of those doubts that either of us have any of these secrets and background goings on. When I finally get to New York, we're going to finally get to be together. We're gonna have a place. And yeah, it may feel a little bit strange at first. I'm going to be very honest. I'm going to be shy as hell when I first get over there and very, very embarrassed. But once I've had a day or two and been with him, you know, actually in person, I'm going to lose that shyness pretty easily.
We have tons of plans, and it's just literally once he moves here, life just starts. It's just IRL life just starts from that point on.